Hello and welcome to the Tokyo Aquatics Centre. Look at that beautiful blue water. Isn't it inviting? It's wonderful to be here for the women's 3-metre springboard. This is the second part of three for this particular event. We've had the preliminaries. We've whittled the field down from 27 to 18. Now we're having the semi-finals. The top 12 are going to qualify for the final. 18 people taking part from 13 different countries. Plenty of them you can see here on your screens now, all happy to be here, as we all are, and we're happy that you're with us, joining us for the best that the Olympics has to offer here at Tokyo 2020. Slow motion as the divers come in. We will have plenty of slow motion for you as we analyse the various dives that the competitors will be performing, 5 each. As we see them warming up, they've already had a warm-up in the pool. That was around half an hour ago. So now, as you can see, you can actually practice some of your dives, not all of them, in the dry. There's an area here that's called dry land around the back of the pools, and that is where the competitors are warming up. 18 of them, and we're going to whittle that down into 12. They will be starting in reverse order from the way that they finished after the preliminaries. So the diver that finished 18th and crept in, just about got in, Annabelle Smith from Australia. She will go first, and then 18th will be Shi Tingmao of China, who is favourite for the gold. And here are the competitors ready to come out. As I've said, they're going in reverse order, so 18 down to 13 will be the ones desperate to creep their way through, try and claw their way into the top 12. Do you think we can see any upsets here, or is the order set in stone already?
Absolutely not set in stone. None of the scores from the preliminary rounds carry through, so it's a clean slate. And as we've all seen with diving, anything can happen. So whilst they might have finished 18th yesterday, they could easily move up into the top 12 to make the finals.
There are various degrees of difficulty, anything between 2.0 and today I think the most ambitious dives we're going to see are 3.5. Is today the semi-final? Is it a day to go for the big ones and try and make sure you get into the top 12? Or do you let discretion be the better part of valour, go for caution?
Well, a couple of the divers from yesterday have changed their programme. Most of them are sticking to the same programme. But Jennifer Abell, she has moved from a 3.0 for her last dive to a 3.4. And Emma Dahlstrand from Sweden, she has also done exactly the same. So Pamela Ware, you mentioned earlier, she has stuck with a 3.5 as well. So a lot of them putting extra difficulty into that final dive, but a number staying with the same program that they qualified for the semi-finals. As we get a chance to look at all of the semi-finalists for today.
So I said it's in reverse order from the way they qualified. So we've had 18th, Annabelle Smith, 17th, Inamoto Haruka, 16th, Inga Jansen, and then 15th there, Krista Palmer.
Tina Punzel, she's already had a really successful games, having won a bronze medal in the 3-metre synchro event. It must be a relief for some of these athletes to know that they have qualified. It's not easy to get through to semi-finals. Nerves would have played a part yesterday as well. And of course, there were a number of divers that were disappointed at not actually making it through to the next stage of the competition. Grace Reed from Great Britain, she just missed out actually on qualifying by I think it's something like 4 or 5 points. There wasn't too much in it anyway.
Barely 4 points. She finished on 268.15, 19th, and she was the first reserve. But unfortunately for her, nobody has pulled out or been forced to pull out, and she was 3.9 behind Annabelle Smith of Australia. Speaking of Australia, Esther Chin. Sixth in Rio 5 years ago. She was actually born in Yeouzhou in China, but she represents Australia. Arantxa Vasquez, she dives for North Carolina, the University of North Carolina, the Tar Heels. She's just 18 years old, but has already moved to the United States to further her career. Hayley Hernandez is going for some very conservative dives today. Two sevens, two eights. Is that just to make sure that she does those to perfection?
Yeah, she wasn't expecting to qualify. She did exceptionally well in the US trials and actually managed to qualify in sixth place with the easiest set of dives. So it is all about the execution. You're better off doing maybe lower degree difficulty, but doing it exceptionally well than a high degree and not doing it so well. As we take a look at Pamela Ware, finished fourth in the preliminaries.
She's doing it the other way around. She's finishing off, as you said, with a 3.5. That'll be interesting to see. Jennifer Abel, she's also going to finish off with a 3.4. She got silver in the synchro 3-meter with Melissa Citrini-Beaulieu. So already medals for Canada there. And now the big two.
Yeah, I think they've got to really dive their absolute best today, though. They were very, very good, obviously. They finished first and second in the preliminary rounds, but they weren't that far ahead of the rest of the field. Shi Tingmao, the current world and Olympic champion. And she does start out as the favourite, but she wasn't so happy with her diving yesterday. You could see that on her face. A couple of the dives she didn't finish first on, and her expectation would be to be first on every single dive as they do some last-minute stretching before they take to the board.
Looking at the judges, there are seven in total. There we go, we saw 3 plus 4. They will all give their scores. There are their names. They'll all give their scores. The top two and the bottom two will be taken off, so that those are the outliers. We're left with the three in the middle, and their combined scores will add up the three middle scores and multiply it by the degree of difficulty. It sounds incredibly difficult. Let us do all the calculations for you. Just enjoy the dives as they happen. Enjoy the dives afterwards in slow motion. Listen to the expert commentary of the person I've got alongside me. You just enjoy it, and we will work out all the scores for you. Who's first, who looks like they're going to qualify, who needs to pick things up between rounds 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Who's on the bubble, who might not qualify. There'll be plenty of suspense and plenty of absolutely beautiful diving for you to enjoy. And it's going to be very quick fire. 18 competitors, 5 rounds, but it all happens in the blink of an eye, so just sit back and enjoy it.
It absolutely does, and that's why the judges are extremely well qualified, because they have a millisecond, really, to make a decision on what they think of each dive.
So much so that there will be a second set of judges who come in after the third round, is it, of dives?
Yes, that's right.
Yes, there we go. Now, enough talk, time to watch some diving. And we're going to get underway with Annabelle Smith, 28-year-old Melbournean.
And a lovely start from her. She also started so well in the preliminary rounds as well. Her first dive actually was her strongest then. She got 63.55 in the preliminary, so be interesting to see how the score compares today. Just letting those heels go over just a fraction, but staying nice and centred on the board. That's a view the judges don't get, obviously.
So it ends up being with 3 sevens multiplied by 3.1. That gives you 65.1. A very good, solid start for her. Reminder that we're going in reverse order, so the first six are the ones who will be thinking, I need to get up into the top 12. Enomoto Haruka of Japan.
Lovely. Very nice. She actually finished in the top 12 on all of her dives in the preliminary rounds, apart from the last one. So she is more than capable of making it through to the finals.
The degree of difficulty was 3 compared with 3.1 for Annabelle Smith, who went before her. And she's not quite hit the heights according to the judges there. 6.5s multiplied by 3, that gives her 58.5. You could hear plenty of photographers taking photos of her when she was in midair. The little bit of pressure on for the local diver. Now we move on to Inge Janssen of the Netherlands.
Yeah, Inge Janssen making her first appearance at an Olympic Games. Good strength off the board. Would have liked to have seen those knees locked out just a little bit more, and she didn't keep those hips square to the board. And these are all little things that the judges will be looking for.
More or less sevens, yes indeed, sevens across the board multiplied by 3. That gives her 63, puts her second out of 3, as we see the stars and stripes being waved for Krista Palmer, 29 years old. 3.0 degree of difficulty.
Nice dive. It was her best dive yesterday as well, the first one. Got off to a really good start, was actually lying 5th after the first round. Knees nicely locked, but again twisted those hips just a little bit.
Well, the judges agreed with you. 6.5s to 7s across the board, and it ends up being multiplied by 3 for 60 on the nose for her. That puts her 3rd out of 4. Tina Punzel, 25 years old, from Dresden in the east of Germany. 3rd in the 3-metre synchro with Lena Henschel. So already has some hardware to take home with her from these games.
Well, that was a better effort than it was in the preliminaries. She got off to a little bit of a shaky start in the earlier round. Only scoring a 45 on this dive, so a significant improvement.
Indeed, it's over 33% better. She's clocked in with 61.5 here, with 7s and 7.5s across the board. Ends up being 2 sevens and a 6.5, but that puts her in 3rd at the moment. 24-year-old Maria Polyakova, from representing the Russian Olympic Committee.
Beautiful extension in her feet. Remember that the judges aren't just looking at the entry, although that is obviously really important because it is the very last thing they see, but they're looking at the flight through the air, which you can see here, and they're looking at the power off the board as well and the approach on the board. So lots for them to look at in the milliseconds while they're going through the dive.
There's quite a variety of scores there, a 5.5 and a 7.5 taken out, so that leaves us with pretty much 20 overall, multiplied by 3, and it's 61.5 for her. She's level with Tina Punzel in 3rd. Emma Holstrand, 20 years old, from Sweden. Again, 3.0 degree of difficulty. We're now into the top 12 from the preliminaries.
Really nice and tight on the pipe position. What you need to look for is the body actually pushed against the legs here. So keeping it as tight as possible, but timing not great, and that's why the legs flipped over a little bit, and that does impact on the judges' scores.
Yes, entry into the water is one of the four criteria that the judges take a look at, and she's currently in seventh. 6.5, 6 and 6 being the scores that count, multiplied by 355.5. It's approach and starting position, takeoff from the springboard, flight through the air and entry are the four criteria that are judged. So let's watch those with 21-year-old Swiss representative Michelle Heimberg. She was 11th in the preliminaries.
Again, a really nice tight pike. Wasn't quite a ripped entry. Let's have a look at it again, but I think the heels went very slightly over, so it didn't hold that vertical position.
Indeed, and she has replicated the score of Emma Hultstrand, so the Swede and the Swiss are next to one another alphabetically, and also on the scoreboard, seventh equal at the moment. ...22-year-old Malaysian Noor Dabita Sabri. Third in the Asian Games 3 years ago. 10th in the preliminaries.
Lovely start. She has so much support back in Malaysia. And it's and you can really see why that is. She started really well yesterday. She got 67.5 for this dive, which actually placed her in the top three just for that dive. Let's see how today compares.
Well, there's only nine taken part so far, but she's currently equal second. Sevens across the board when you take out the outliers, even with it, sevens and 7.5s multiplied by three. She's on 63, level with Inga Janssen. At the moment, it's the first diver from Australia, Annabelle Smith, who is in the lead. Let's see what her compatriot Esther Chin can do.
Lovely, fantastic start. Arms up in the air from the coach. The first dive was her best yesterday in the preliminaries. And you can see why. She scored 66 then.
You can hear those seven and a halfs and eights. And she has shot to the top of the leaderboard, 69. So at the moment, a couple of Aussies atop the board. Annabelle Smith in second with 65.1. Esther Chin first on 69. Obviously, we still have eight divers to go, but a good start from the Aussies. Arantxa Vasquez of Mexico, the 18-year-old who now dives for the University of North Carolina.
Great start. She had to really fight hard in the preliminary rounds because her first dive actually wasn't strong. She only scored 52.50. Look at the power that she gets here. This dive was so, so much better. Forehead right up on those legs.
As you could hear in the background, plenty of seven and a halves to be multiplied by three, and she's up into second, splitting the Aussies. 67.5, just 1.5 behind Esther Chin, who is currently in the lead. Seven divers still to come. Kim Suji of Korea, 23 years old. And she shares a birthday with me, so I'm going to keep a close eye on her and cross my fingers.
Very consistent yesterday. We're in the preliminary rounds. She just gets up there. She knows what she has to do. Really nice in the pike. But again, the feet just topping over just a little bit. One of the divers has gone from originally being on 10 meter. That was back in 2012 at the Olympic Games. Didn't compete in Rio and now back competing on the 3 meter.
And she's in the middle of the pack at the moment. She's one of three divers on 63, putting her fourth. The youngster, Haley Hernandez, just 18 years old, won the Grand Prix in California 2 years ago.
Great start. She has the easiest set of dives, but I think she's made a really, really good decision. A lot of her dives are in the tuck, whereas most of the divers go into the pike position. But even with an easier set of dives of 2.7, 2.8, she is still right up there because the execution is just so good.
Well, the degree of difficulty of just 2.7 has worked a little bit against her here. As you can see, she's getting sevens, but the coefficient multiplied by 2.7 gives her just 56.7. That puts her 11th out of 13 at the moment. Mikami Sayaka of Japan. 20 years old, her degree of difficulty a 3. She was 5th in the preliminaries. Listen for the photographers who are going to start clicking as soon as she's in the air.
Yeah, I do love to watch her diving. Currently ranked 5th in the world, and I think she does stand a real chance of a medal in the 3 meter individual when it comes to through to the finals, but she's got to keep being as consistent as she is at the moment.
Sevens and seven and a halves multiplied by 3 gives her 64.5. That puts her 4th at the moment, with 4 of her competitors still to come in this first round. Now we're going to have a pair of Canadians followed by the Chinese duo. Pamela Ware first up, 28 years old, 7th in Rio 5 years ago. Degree of difficulty here, 3.0.
Well, she loves her tattoos. Her coach was very happy with that. Aaron Diver.
I don't know who's throwing in the towel. It's certainly not Pamela Ware.
Definitely not. And she will be going with the hardest dive of 3.5 as her last dive. So she also did that dive yesterday. She hasn't changed her program between the preliminaries and the finals.
That was a 3.0 degree of difficulty, 7.5s across the board. 67.5 puts her equal second with Arantxa Vázquez. Now her fellow Canadian, Jennifer Abel. Third in the preliminaries, second in the synchro with Melissa Citrini-Beaulieu. So she always already has a silver to her name.
That will steady any nerves. Coach Arturo Miranda, you can always tell with him whether his divers have had a good day or not, but that was a great start from Jennifer Abel. Finished fourth in Rio and was very, very disappointed with that because she was in third place until the last dive.
Well, two Canadians have replicated one another. They are level pegging with Arantxa Vázquez of Mexico, second on 67.5. Still Esther Chin of Australia in the lead. Now the big two, Wang Han first from China, 30 years old, first in the Asian Games 3 years ago. And the two still to come, Wang Han and Shi Tingmao, won the 3 meter synchro.
Lovely, lovely start. Yes, competed together in the synchro, now competing against each other on the individual. Look how tight that pike is. Look how straight the legs are.
Well, the judges agree. And you could hear some 7.5s and 8s there. And Wang has edged into the lead. She's 1.5 ahead of Esther Chin, 70.5, laying down a marker for her synchro teammate, Shi Tingmao, the Rio gold medalist, Asian Games gold medalist, Wuhan 2018 World Cup gold medalist, 29 years old, the favourite here, and the last person to dive in this opening round.
Well, you could have heard a pin drop before that dive. The concentration on her face. She has such high expectation of herself, and that's probably why she's achieved so much over the years. Wasn't entirely comfortable yesterday, but still managed to get that first place in the preliminary rounds.
Wasn't entirely comfortable here by her high standards. A couple of sevens and a 7.5. 64.5. That puts her equal seventh. So, of the Chinese duo, it's Wang who has got her nose in front. Esther Chin second. And then Arantxa Vasquez of Mexico, Pamela Ware and Jennifer Abel third. Shi Tingmao down in seventh. Equal seventh. Reminder that the top 12 will go through to the final. So no one is really out of it as we speak at the moment. That was the first of five rounds. Now, the order will remain the same throughout. So we're going to begin once again with Annabel Smith, who started 18th in inverted commas, but as we said earlier, clean slate compared with the preliminaries. Annabel Smith, I suppose, from the preliminaries, number 18 seed. She's already up to sixth, so that's a cracking performance from the 28-year-old from Melbourne.
Again, very steady. We get another chance to have a look at it. Actually her third Olympics, but her very first time in the individual competition. It's always been a synchro up until now, taking a bronze 5 years ago.
Pretty much the same score as she got in the first round. The degree of difficulty was slightly lower, 3.0 as opposed to 3.1. After 65.1 in the first round, 63 in the second. In the Moto of Japan, 3.1, so slightly more difficult. She's currently hoping to get into the top dozen.
The timing was good. They do seem to hit those verticals pretty well. Very much over to one side on the board, which you probably saw there. The judges won't see that as much as we can, though, because they sit either side of the pool. Yeah, I think she's saying to her coach, because it makes it very hard to actually get the dive in. 58.90 for her.
Yes, after a 58.5, so she's currently on the outside looking in. Inge Janssen, 27-year-old from the Netherlands.
Good height off the board. Moved quite a long way from the actual diving board. It's important to be far enough away, but you don't want to be too far away.
63, so the same as Annabel Smith, but she was slightly behind the Aussie in the first round. She was ninth overall after that first round. Krista Palmer from the USA, 29-year-old. She was down in 15th after the first round, so we'll be looking for a good dive here. 3.0 degree of difficulty.
Good. Brought up a little bit too much water on the entry. She loves diving in a red, white and blue costume. Very, very patriotic, of course. Well, Didn't actually start competing in diving until she was 20, but she was a world-class trampolinist before then. But I had to finish because it was too much pressure on her knees. But gosh, isn't she doing well with her diving?
She is. As you say, the entry wasn't perfect. That probably cost her a few points there. 54. So she was 14th after the first round. And that's the fourth best dive so far out of four. Tina Punzel of Germany.
Lots of power off the board. She looks a lot more confident today. In the preliminaries, just looked a little bit shaky on the first couple of dives. Left herself a lot to do. Just let the heels come over a little bit.
Well, she was 12th after the first round. She's put in the best dive of the second round so far by an absolute foul, just ahead of Annabelle Smith and Inge Janssen, who are on 63. She's on 63.55. So no one's setting the world alight at the moment amongst the top five. Now diving Maria Poliakova, 3.0 degree of difficulty, 12th equal after the first round.
Lives in Kazan currently, but studied at the University of California, where she did a lot of her training. Just keep the knees locked. I like to see the knees locked straight away, as early as they possibly can, rather than when they unfold from the pike position.
Well, the judges obviously wanted to see them locked as well. Sixes across the board multiplied by three. 6, 12, 18 times 3 gives you 54. Emma Holstrand, 3.1 degree of difficulty. She will be hoping to pick up bigger points than she did in the first round. 17th out of 18. A reminder, the top 12 will qualify. Five dives each.
Feet slightly coming over, which I'm sure you saw as well. As we take another look at it, another one who trains in the United States at the University of Miami. And that was, unfortunately, quite a bit of, they call it, washing the legs over, and has been penalised for that.
Yes, a slightly higher degree of difficulty, but just 5.5s for her. So that makes 16.5 multiplied by 3.1, which I'm sure you can do in your head at home. 51.15, that's 7th out of 7 of the ones who have gone so far. Michelle Heimberg, she was also towards the back of the pack after the first round. So we'll be looking for a good one here to get her into the top 12.
When you watch it on the replay, you'll notice when she does a twist that her legs slightly come apart. That's something that the judges will be looking for, that the heels stay together. There it was. And a little bit heavy on the entry. Came up through the Youth Olympic route, as a lot of these divers do, getting wonderful experience at the Youth Olympics before then coming to their first Olympic Games.
Once the outliers are removed, it's 6 plus 6 plus 6, makes 18, multiplied by 3, 54. One of three divers to get 54. Best dive so far, Tina Punzel, 63.55. What can Noor Dabita Sabri do?
Well, she can do pretty well. She gets so much height. Keep the knees straight. That's good. Very good. Very, very slightly twisted as she entered the water, if I'm being ultra critical. But these are the things that the judges will be looking for. but still a very good dive indeed, and she looks happy with that.
3 sevens, 21 multiplied by 3.1, 65.1. That is the best dive of the round and puts her equal first with Annabel Smith overall. Esther Chin, who was well up there, second after the first round. A tougher dive.
A good dive. Felt that she maybe moved a little bit too far away from the board. She actually started diving in China. Moved from China to Australia in 2009 after her dad got a job as a chef. Very slightly over to the side on one board, and I think that probably had an impact.
5.5s across the board, 51.15. That takes her down from second to fifth at the moment. That's the equal lowest score in this round so far. Arantxa Vázquez, who was third despite starting 11th overall.
Something I notice about her dives is that when she's doing the approach, remember the judges are looking for posture as well. And actually you should look down with your eyes but up with your head, where she tends to look down with her head as well to see where she's going. Head is very low.
Well, she's a teenager, and I know from bitter experience that you have to tell teenagers, come on, shoulders back, head up. But obviously she would do well to listen to that. 3 sevens, though, multiplied by 3.1, and that is the equal best score of the round, equal best with Noor Dabita Sabri, and that puts her in the lead by 4.5 points. Kim Suji, who was ninth after the first round.
I thought it was good in the air, what they call the flight, quickly into the pike. Would have liked to have seen even tighter at the beginning of that pike. She sort of closed it as she was doing the rotations and then slightly over-egged it for the entry.
The judges agree with you on the over-egging on the entry. It was 5.5s. I think there was also a 4.5 in there that was wiped off. So fives across the board. 3.1, that's a 46.5, so the least impressive dive so far in the second round. Haley Hernandez.
They're the youngest diver here, just out of high school. She's just graduated. She said that she actually nearly quit when she was sort of middle school age, because she had a real fear of learning new dives and taking it to the next level. I bet that she is very, very glad that she did push through. But as I said before, always has to do exceptionally well because her dives are easier.
2.8 degree of difficulty, so that's barked her down a little bit. 6.5s across the board gives her 54.6. So that's the seventh best dive this round so far, and she's currently sitting in 10th, but obviously with five divers still to go. Mikami Sayaka of Japan, seventh after the first round. Reminder, 12 will qualify, 3.1 degree of difficulty.
Nice. On some of these dives, not on that particular one, but on some of them where they actually rotate backwards, they have to be very, very aware that they mustn't be too close to the board. And she did actually hit the board a few years ago and actually needed 17 stitches as a result of it. So, but a nice dive from her there.
17 stitches, but 22 points overall. Two 7.5s and a 7. Multiply that by 3.1 and you get 68.2. It's the best dive of the round so far. And puts 0.1 in the lead ahead of Arantxa Vázquez Montano. But obviously we have the two Canadians and the two Chinese divers to come. Pamela Ware first. She was third equal after the first round.
Well, this was her best dive in the preliminaries. A big fist pump from the coach. Been in the national team since 2007, so very, very experienced.
Sevens across the board multiplied by 3.1, 65.1. Equal second best dive of the round so far. Puts her equal second overall. 0.1 separate the top three at the moment, but the next three still to come. Jennifer Abel, who was equal third after the first round.
Excellent. Really good positioning off the board. She's certainly having a good game so far.
Listen to those scores.
Her coach loves working with her, he says, because she always brings fun to the training. She's a bit of a practical joker, apparently. Very slightly over to one side on the board. As we said before, the judges won't pick up on that quite as much as we have, and it didn't seem to affect the actual flight. There's her coach, Arturo Miranda.
3.8 multiplied by 3.1, 74.4, by far and away the best dive so far. 6 points clear of the rest, puts her 9 points clear at the top. But now we have Wang Han of China in the lead after the first round. Difficulty of 3.0.
Well, they may not have the fans here, but how intimidating is that, having to dive in front of all of those cameras? But what a lovely dive it was. She has so much. Her legs look so, so straight. She did flip over a little bit. She had to try and save it. But a really, really good dive.
Eights across the board multiplied by three give her 72. Enough to maintain her lead. Just about by 0.6 points from Jennifer Abel. Abel with 74.4 this round, Wang with 72, and now the last diver, Shi Tingmao. A disappointing seventh after the first round. Degree of difficulty 3.
Well, she puts pressure on herself all the time. And as you say, certainly after the first dive, she needed to come out here and do something pretty special. Would have been good to see the feet pointed a little bit earlier. Don't like to see a flat foot too much.
Seven and a halves and eight and a halves are ruled out. She ends up with 2.8 and an 8.5 multiplied by 3. 73.5, second best dive of the round, gets her up from seventh to third overall.
That's more like it for her.
Yes, clawing her way back up. And obviously we've only had two rounds thus far, another three to go. So not even halfway through. Wang Han still in the lead, despite the third best dive of the round. Jennifer Abel gets herself up to second, third is Shi Tingmao, and then after that, three other divers incredibly close together, the French have a saying for it. They say you could fit them in a pocket handkerchief. Look at that, 0.1 between the three of them. Reminder that the top 12 qualify, so the cutoff at the moment is Enomoto, 117.4, but obviously not a lot to... not a lot between 12th and 18th at the moment, just 11 points separating them, so everyone still very much in the running. Round three, we're going to maintain the running order throughout. So it's back to Annabelle Smith. She was third after the first round, seventh overall at the moment.
Having a good day. She must be feeling that She qualified yesterday. That 18th place, that all-important 18th place. Actually, she's got nothing to lose to really come out here and give it as much as she can. She let her legs come apart, and that's why the judges' scores aren't as high as she would have liked.
A few 5.5s wiped off and a 7. That gives her a couple of 6.5s and a 5.5. 55.5 for her after she scored 63 and 65, so she'll be a little bit disappointed there. Enomoto of Japan, 12th at the moment, so she is the cut-off point for qualification.
Yeah, again, not really getting the timing as perfectly as she could have done, just letting the legs drop over just a little bit. Nice stretch on the pike, but that all-important entry, and as we say, that's the last thing the judges see, and that's the bit you really need to nail to get that ripped entry. You don't want any water coming up. You almost want to pull the water down with you. 46.50.
A couple of 58s in the first two rounds, and so a bit of a drop-off there for Enomoto. Inga Jansen in the top 10.
Okay, she really does like to dive away from the board, but she's very, very strong in the air. Lock the knees out a little bit. And don't let the legs just drop over. You can see the front of her legs just hitting the water there as her toes go under.
Well, that's the third diver in a row who has failed to replicate the scores of the first two rounds. Her drop-off was less significant. She had a couple of 63s. This one is a 58.5. Makes her the clubhouse leader, to use a golfing term, just ahead of Annabelle Smith. Now we have Krista Palmer, degree of difficulty 3. She's just outside of that top dozen that you need to be in to make it through to the final.
Right on the end of the board there. I think she's a very elegant diver to watch. And I like that she gives so much back in her community, visiting schools to encourage them into sport.
Well, the judges have given it back to her. That's her best dive so far after a 54 in round two, 60 in round one. That's 61.5. Gets her up into third at the moment. She was 14th after the first round, 13th after the second. Let's see if she can get into the top 12, courtesy of that one. Tina Punzel of Germany, rounding out the top 10 after two rounds.
And again, right on the end of the board. That was nice. That's where you're going to get the maximum spring from. She had a good year this year. Won the European Championship title back in June.
Well, she's been consistent so far, and the judges were consistent. Sevens across the board after a 61.5 and a 63.5. That's a 63 on the nose. That puts her in the lead in this particular round. The best of this round, and that puts her top of the table at the moment after just 5 out of 18 in this round. Maria Poliakova, 13th at the moment.
Yeah, 13th at the moment, so really at that cut-off point. Remember, it's only the top 12 that go through to the finals.
Similar score to the second round where she got 54, 55.5. So not the kind of dive that's going to thrust her into the top 10. Currently makes her 5th out of 6. Emma Holstrand. She struggled in the previous round and currently finds herself 18th out of the 18. Only 10 points off the top 12 though.
Nice diving. Took a bronze in the European Championships just a few weeks ago. So living in the States. Comes originally from Jönköping in Sweden, which hosted the European Championships, gosh, a long time ago now, back in 1977.
Good grief. Well before she was born. Six out of seven in this round. It's similar to what she got in the first two rounds, 54, so that currently has her seventh out of seven. Not too far off the pack. From Sweden to Switzerland, 16th overall, Michelle Heimberg, 3.1 degree of difficulty, so a good dive here would get her into the top dozen.
That was a nice dive. She's somebody that enjoys all the twists and the turns, started out as an artistic gymnast, but decided to change to diving because she had a few injuries, particularly with the knees. Lovely tight pike, just didn't quite nail that all-important entry. Feet coming very slightly apart.
And that's why the judges gave her sixes across the board once we get rid of the outliers. 3.1 degree of difficulty though, 55.8. Fourth best dive out of eight so far. So keeps her in touch with the pack. Nor Dabita Sabri. She was seventh after round two. Degree of difficulty three. So she needs to execute well here to maintain that position in the top ten.
Yeah, that should be good enough. Competes in the Commonwealth Games as well, took a bronze medal in the 10 metre synchro. So a very good diver on 3 metre and 10 metre. Very adaptable.
Once the outliers are out, we have sevens across the board. And that gives her a score of 63. It's the best so far this round, level with Tina Punzel, and that puts her at the top of the table, 191.1, three clear off Punzel.
And she just looks like she's enjoying every moment of it. That's so lovely to see.
Esther Chin, great first dive, less so second. She's currently probably a little bit nervous. She was 11th after the second round.
Good. It's at times like this when you know that you might be slightly behind and you want to move up the rankings where sports psychology really plays an important part. If you're not confident, if you're not right in the head, then the dive will never work.
6.5s. That gives her 58.5. So in between her two dives, she had a 51 in the second round, a 69 in the first, and that's in between the two. So that's going to keep her in the middle of the pack. Arantxa Vázquez of Mexico, fifth after the second round, after getting off to a flying start, degree of difficulty three.
Lots of power off the board, and you need that to be able to fit in all the somersaults that you do and the twists that you do in the air. Get those feet pointed. She pointed them at the end. That was good, but we don't like to see flat feet.
So, head up, shoulders back, no flat feet. Couple of sevens and a 6.5. It's the third best dive of the round, 61.5. And that puts her in the lead at the moment after 11 of the 18 divers. Moving on to Kim Suji. She was 16th after the second round. Definitely needs a good dive here. 2.8 degree of difficulty, so she's going to have to absolutely get it spot on.
Nice dive. I do like it when the coaches look happy and look like they're smiling under their masks. I mean, she is an incredible diver. Point those toes, though. I keep saying that, don't I? She actually was the youngest diver to ever qualify for Korea back in 2012. So what a career she's having.
57.4, that was a couple of sevens and a 6.5 remaining, just the 2.8 degree of difficulty. So middle of the pack for this round, seventh out of 12 so far. Might be just about enough. That'll get her around the top 12. Now we have Hayley Hernandez again, just a 2.8 degree of difficulty. She's 15th. Again, needs a perfect dive here.
And she did a really, really good dive there. As you said, it needed to be because it was the lower degree difficulty. Lovely to see the support they're getting here. And I mean, her dreams were all about qualifying for Paris, so this is an absolute bonus for her at the age of 18 to be here in Tokyo as well.
One of the people for whom the delay has really been a great benefit. It's given an extra year to hone her skills, to be old enough and mature enough to compete. She's getting 7.5s here. Degree of difficulty, not the greatest, but she did an excellent job. That 63 equal best dive of the round. That drags her up into eighth spot at the moment with five to come. So she is now in the qualification conversation. Mikami.
Oh, no. That went wrong on the board. I could see she was right over to the right-hand side. What a dreadful, dreadful shame for her. She's been doing so, so well, but this is not good. You can see she almost fell off the board sideways. She did so well to even get through that. But enough said on the scores, which I'm sure that you can hear. Such a shame for her.
19.5 overall. So that drops her from fourth to 14th out of 14 at the moment, so it's pretty clear that she's going to be 18th out of 18. By no means out of it, though. She's only 10 or 15 behind qualification because she had two very good rounds. On to the first of the two Canadians as we get into the final four, Pamela Ware.
Being very, very consistent here. What she does have is real power off the board, and she is able to attempt for her final dive a 3.5 that a lot of the other divers wouldn't be able to do. And that's because of the power that she does get off the board.
Well, you liked it, the coach liked it, and the judges agreed. Two sevens and a 7.5 multiplied by three, 64.5. That's the best dive we've had so far this round. That puts her 3 points clear at the top, but with three still to come, one of whom is her fellow Québécoise, Jennifer Abel.
Really good to see her diving so well here. Coach immediately going round to have a chat with her, one foot in front of the other, as you can see there, but she still managed to control it, but it might have slightly affected her. She will be 30 years of age next month. She's actually the youngest diver in Beijing back in 2008. What a career that she is having. Incredible.
2 6.5s plus 7, that makes 20, multiplied by 3, 60 on the nose. Seventh best dive of the round, just 4.5 behind her compatriot. But that puts her 5 clear at the top at the moment, but obviously we have the two Chinese divers still to come. Wang in the lead after the first two rounds.
Just beautiful extension in the legs and feet. She's 30 years of age, which is, in Chinese diving, is actually quite old, and this is her first Olympics. But she herself says that she just wasn't ready before and has so much admiration for her teammates, but what an incredible dive that was.
Yes, the judges agree with you. Two 8.5s makes 17, another 8 makes 25. Multiply that point 3 by 3 and you get 75. The best dive of the round by 10 clear points. She is now 16 points clear at the top. What can her teammate from the synchro, Shi Tingmao, say about that? She hoisted herself up to third after a poor first round. Can she follow in the footsteps and the flight of her teammate?
Yeah, she seems to give herself quite a lot of time in the air and almost does a gentle entry into the water. Not much splash coming up at all. And although it is about, get those knees straight, it is about getting into the top 12, it's really important to get as high a position as possible because it does affect where you actually dive in the finals. But lovely dive there.
It's the end of round three. The judges are being substituted out because, good grief, they have had 54 dives to judge already. So is my co-commentator, but she's not going anywhere. She's going to carry on with her eagle eye, talking us through all of these dives. As we can see, three-fifths of the way through, it's shaken itself out rather nicely. The two Chinese divers leading, followed by the two Canadians. That's the way it finished, more or less, after the preliminary round, and that's how it is here in the semi-finals. A reminder that it's top 12 who qualify. So we've got the Aussies 9 and 10, the Americans 11 and 12. The rest of them still incredibly close. Even Mikami, who just got 19 points in that final round, she is only 20 points away from qualification, 22 to be absolutely accurate.
You've got to be impressed with Shi Tingmao, mustn't you? Because she was something like sixth, I think it was, for memory, in the first round, and she has fought her way back to be right up there again.
Just 3 points behind her teammate. They're going neck and neck at the moment. Yes, she was 6 points behind her teammate in the first round, and she's dragged herself back to within three. Here are the new judges. No changes in the commentary box. And no changes in the running order. It will stay the same for rounds 4 and 5. Most people, most divers going for 3s and 3.1s, but we'll see the odd 3.4 and 3.5 coming in the final round. Round 4, Annabelle Smith. Ninth. Her teammate Esther Chin is 10th. Top 12 qualify. Averaging around 60 at the moment. She'd like a 65 here just to solidify that spot in the top 12.
Oh dear. So she will get some penalties for having started and having a restart as we look at the coaches. Andy Banks on the right there. Couldn't really see what they were thinking. She needs to regroup. And all credit to her for doing a pretty good dive. She scored 49.50 for this in the preliminary rounds.
Well, she's got fours and four and a halfs and a penalty of 2 for the restart. That gives her 39 overall. It's a big call from her, but we saw in the previous round Mikami getting a dive completely wrong and getting 19. So a 39 overall, it's obviously not ideal, but it's better than it could have been for a completely failed dive. And, of course, you can get 0 if you enter feet first. So she limited the damage here, but just 39 points.
Gosh. That, she just lost it at the end. sometimes it can be distracting if the diver in front of you does something wrong, because you're all mentally prepared for your dive and then you need to regroup yourself. I'm not saying that definitely affected her, but perhaps. But she was right over to the side of the board again and just lost, didn't get those heels together.
No penalty here, but fours across the board, and that is just 36. So we've seen a 39 and a 36 thus far. Inga Jansen, eighth after three rounds.
Yep, that's more like it. Nice and tight on the pike, but you'll see there the heels just go over a little bit, and because of that, it's not a ripped entry.
Couple of 6.5s and a 6, multiplied by 3.1, because it was a slightly more difficult dive. That gives her 58.9, more or less what she scored in the third round. And that makes her the clubhouse leader. Krista Palmer. 3.1 degree of difficulty, 11th after the first round, but obviously we've seen a few divers in this fourth round struggling to make decent scores, so an opportunity for her to consolidate a place in the top 10.
And she really maximises on that. Lovely dive from Krista. So she has to work really hard on keeping those legs strong to get as much power off the board, but all that work she's been putting into it in the gym is certainly paying off.
Her dives are getting better as we go along. She was 14th in round one, 13th in round two. This one is the best we've seen so far in round four, 69.75. How about that for her? An excellent dive, and doesn't she know it? That puts her in the lead. Tina Punzel, again, looking to solidify a top 10 spot.
Always such a lot to look at in that dive, isn't there? And the judges, I feel for them sometimes. They are so highly trained, though, to really look at the body alignment, the tight pikes. It was a good dive from Tina.
It was. Sevens across the board, multiplied by three. 7, 14, 21, multiply that by three, gives you 63. That puts her in the lead at the moment, six clear of Krista Palmer. Maria Poliakova, she was on the outside looking in, 13th after three rounds. Degree of difficulty three, but there's a spot in the top 12 open for her.
Yep, there certainly is. I'd like to see it again. I wasn't sure if her legs were slightly over her face. We've seen a lot of legs going over a little bit. I just wonder if she was a little bit under here, but I might be wrong.
No, the judges back you up on that one. Sixes across the board multiplied by three, 6, 12, 18. Triple that gives you 54. So that's the least impressive of the conventional score, shall we say, in this round, bearing in mind Enamor Tor got 36 and Annabel Smith 39. Emma Hulstrand, 17th after three rounds, but obviously, as we've seen, spots still up for grabs if you can score consistently and keep a poor dive off your card of five.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You can't afford one bad dive, really, in this competition. All five dives have to be consistently good. There's no opportunity to say, actually, I wasn't very happy with that. I'd really like to do it again. And you need to remember to really think ahead and not think about dives that you've already done if they haven't gone the way that you want them to. You just need to forget it and move on.
6.5s, so that makes 19.5. Multiply that by 3, 58.5. It's her best dive so far. Puts her 6th on the board at the moment. She was 17th coming into that round. That's a solid score. It keeps her up there. Michelle Heimberg, she was 15th. Again, the same applies to her. A good dive here, and she could be in the top 12.
Yeah, this was her best dive in the preliminary rounds. She scored 66 for this dive. It'll be interesting to see how it compares.
Six, seven, six, six and a half, six, six and a half.
2 6.5s and a 6 makes 19. Multiply it by 3. It's like playing darts here. We've got triple 19. Triple 19 gives you 57. So not quite as good as Emma Hullstrand. She remains ahead of her on the scoreboard. 0.3 behind Annabelle Smith, who had that disastrous dive. Noor Dabita Sabri, she was 6th. She's creeping away up the scoreboard.
And is brimming with confidence, the way she approached that. Wasn't perfect alignment as she entered the water, but she looks like she's enjoying every moment of this.
How about this for consistency?
That looked like really hard work there. She just needs to keep those heels together a little bit. But the judges, well, I say they wouldn't have seen it as much as we do, but I bet they did, actually.
63, 65.1, 63 and 63. Absolute rock-solid consistency in 4 rounds so far. She is the leader with 9 dives on the board. Esther Chin, just on the edge of the top 10.
Oh, that's much better from her. Very nice diving there. Competes in the 1 metre as well, so obviously really likes the springboard. 1 metre, not an Olympic event, but it is in the World Championships.
7.5 for her, multiplied by 3. That gives you 67.5. Second best dive of the round after Krista Palmer. And that puts her just ahead of Krista Palmer by 0.9 points. It's going to be very tight indeed. The current top 5 separated by around 10 points.
And that was much better than yesterday's dive, so she'll be happy with that.
Arantxa Vázquez Montano, been incredibly strong thus far, averaging around 65 per dive. She'll be looking for that again.
Another youngster, just 18 years of age in her debut Olympic Games, and coming out here and doing a strong performance. She really does get great height off the board. A good extension as well. Just the feet coming over a little bit, over-rotating.
3 times 7 makes 21, times 3 for the degree of difficulty makes 63. She is now top of the leaderboard. Looking very good to qualify with 1 dive to go. Kim Suji, 14th, so an opportunity for her to get into that top dozen that qualifies for the final.
Another one that just comes out here, dives very, very quickly. There's no hanging around at all. She knows what she needs to go out there and do.
6.5s across the board on a degree of difficulty of 3. That puts her in the middle of the pack as far as this round is concerned, and stuck below the middle of the pack. That 58.5 isn't quite going to be enough to propel her into the top 12 as things stand. Hayley Hernandez sticking with the dives of lower complexity, 2.8. She's currently 12th.
Didn't feel was comfortable watching her on that dive. When she kicked out after the tug, her legs were slightly too far apart there. But overall, not a bad attempt. But she's been dreaming of being at an Olympic Games since the age of 7. And as I say, wasn't expecting to qualify for Tokyo. Did an incredible job at the Olympic trials to finish second to be here. But her aim as well is Paris.
58.8, that keeps her there or thereabouts. She's ahead of 6 other divers at the moment, just about in there in terms of qualification. Mikami, who had that terrible dive last time out.
Wow, that's what she's capable of. She can be absolutely brilliant. She's ranked 5th in the world. So if she doesn't make it into that top 12 because of the dive in the last round, I'd be dreadfully disappointed for her.
It's the second best dive of the round so far. It gets 7.5s. Multiply that by 3 and the coach is delighted that she's got back on track. She's ahead of Emma Holstrand. She's ahead of Enomoto.
That takes resilience, doesn't it, to come back like that?
She's still in with a shout with 1 round to go. She's only 3 behind the likes of Annabelle Smith and Michelle Heimberg. Now, into the Canadians. Pamela Ware, the one with a lot of ink. She's currently 4th.
Wasn't one of her best, getting that over-rotation coming into it. But I think it will be good enough. Remember, they only need to qualify in the top 12 to get through to the finals, and she really is right up there. Started doing diving because her dad promised her an ice cream if she would do a backflip into the water. And an eagle-eyed pool guard noticed how good she was and recommended the local diving club.
There we go. She's going to be disappointed with that one. A couple of 5.5s and a 5.48. That's by far and away her least spectacular dive of the 4. And she's behind Krista Palmer now. So we have an American in amongst the Canadians and the Chinese. Can Jennifer Abel keep her spot in the top 3?
Well, so far she's having really great Olympic Games. Took silver in the synchro event a few days ago and said that she really couldn't ask for a better day than that day after finishing 4th in Rio to come back and take the silver. It was very, very special indeed. And I'm sure that's inspired her for the individual as well.
7s across the board, that's 63. She is one of 4 divers to register 63 in this round. Nordabita, Tina Punzel, Arantxa Vasquez. That puts her in the lead, but obviously the 2 Chinese divers are still to come. Wang Han, who has been leading the pack ever since the very first round. 3.1 degree of difficulty.
Wasn't one of her very best entries. The flight was really good, so that's everything in the air. This was good as well. Plenty of height off that board, plenty of time to get in the rotations, but just missed the entry.
Well, you heard it here first. It wasn't one of her best, and the judges backed that up with 2 sixes and a 6.5, multiplied by 3.1 degree of difficulty. 57.35, that was only the 12th best dive of the round, and bear in mind we had 2 that were, one had penalties, the other one was completely and utterly missed in terms of timing. So she's still in the lead, but now Shi Tingmao, who has dragged away up from 7th to 3rd to 2nd, top spot beckons. Again, degree of difficulty 3.1.
beautiful diving. That's what I like about her. She can be behind the pack, but she knows what she's got to do to gradually rise up again. She will want to qualify in first place. Even though it's the semi-finals, she will be wanting to dive last in the finals. And it's all so close.
Best dive of the round, almost the best dive of the day. But she, Tingmao, has the two best dives of the day. How about that? 2.8s and an 8.5 on a difficulty of 3.1. 75.95 tells the rest of the field I am the person to beat. She is 15 and a half points clear at the top of her teammate Wang Han. Jennifer Abel still in third. Then the pack's been shaken up a fair bit. We've seen Pamela Ware slump from fourth to ninth, and then Kim Suji, and look at that, 0.4 separating 12th and 13th. That is the cutoff point. 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, all within 3 points of one another, looking for qualification. Annabel Smith is one of those. She is 14th at the moment. A good dive here will get her into the top 12. A good dive here will put pressure on those around her, the likes of Kim Suji, Maria Polyakova. It's a 3.0 degree of difficulty for the 28-year-old from Melbourne. A spot in the finals awaits if she can get this dive right.
Well, she couldn't have done it much better than that. Really nice dive. Moved away from home back in 2012. Found it really hard, but wanted to focus on being her absolute best as a diver. And that was a lovely dive. She'll just have to wait and see whether it is enough to qualify through to the finals.
In the last round, she had the penalties, which really knocked her down, but that's a solid dive. Four solid dives out of five, 63. It lays down a marker for those who are close to her, and her coach knows she's given it her best. We just kind of have to wait and see. Enomoto, last after getting one of her dives very wrong last time out.
Yes, certainly has left herself too much to do, but showing real resilience, which is appreciated by the coaches coming out here for her final dive.
A solid, if unspectacular, dive from her. She left herself too much to do. Round three wasn't great. Round four got it completely and utterly wrong. Perhaps we were thinking a little bit put off by the troubles that Annabel Smith had. 55.5 in that final dive for her. Inga Janssen, 10th after the fourth round. A good dive here, we'll see her qualify for the final.
Well, her aim has always been to compete at an Olympic Games, and she certainly got through the preliminary rounds, and I feel sure that that will be good enough to get her through into the finals as well. Just have to wait and see.
It's a decent dive. It puts her first on the scoreboard at the moment, 58.5. That ought to be enough to get her through in the top 12. Now, Krista Palmer. She hoisted herself up to eighth with an excellent dive last time around, 3.4 degree of difficulty. Will she be regretting going for this big gamble here? Let's see what she can pull off in the final round. Very complex dive.
Well, it's a complex dive, but it's also her favourite dive, and that's probably why she put it last. She is more than capable of doing this fantastic dive, 3.4 degree difficulty, and she loves to do it.
I can see why it's her favourite dive. 7777. Multiply that by 3.4. And as you mathematicians out there know, that gives you 71.4. What a score for her.
Thumbs up. She is
definitely through. She is the first person definitely to have qualified. Well done, Krista Palmer. Yes, indeed. Thumbs up. Now, Tina Punsell, sixth so far. Degree of difficulty 3. Needs a solid dive here to remain in the top 12 to qualify for the final.
Yep, that should be plenty good enough. Again, really lovely and tight in that pike. Look at the power of the legs. Straight into that tight pike, beautiful. Legs going over slightly on the entry, but it will be good enough to qualify.
A 7 and 2 6.5s, that gives you 20. Multiply it by the degree of difficulty of 3.0. 60 on the nose.
I feel like I'm having a maths lesson here.
She's 5 points behind Krista Palmer. Now, this is an important one. 13th, so just outside.
Well, she left the best till last in the preliminaries yesterday. She scored 63.55 for this particular dive then.
65.1 this time around.
Even better.
Second best dive of the round. Very well executed. Sevens all the way for a degree of difficulty of 3.1, 290.1. That should be enough to get her in the top 12. Now, Emma Hallstrand, 17th, a degree of difficulty of 3.4. Will this be enough to catapult her up from 17th into the top 12?
Well, she changed this dive from what she did in the preliminary rounds. There she just did a 3.0, but she's just shown that she is more than capable of doing this 3.4 dive. And if she doesn't make it, well, I think all credit to her for giving it everything. Nice dive.
She's given it everything. Two sevens and a 6.5 on a huge degree of difficulty. I'm not going to try to work that one out in my head. The scoreboard says 69.7. How about that? Second best dive of the round. She's wearing the Tre Krona on her chest there, proudly representing her country, and she's given herself every chance of making it through to the final. She's just behind Maria Polyakova, though. Michelle Heimberg with a lot to do and a dive of 3.0.
Another nice dive. Really quickly into that pike and very, very tight on the pike position, which was great. So many of them choosing to do the pike here, not the tuck.
Beautifully executed, 7.5 from all of the judges, gives her 67.5, gets her just ahead of Emma Hallstrand. What might be crucial is she's 0.3 behind Maria Polyakova.
Okay, not wasting any time at all. Really nice diving. Slightly over one side of the board there, feet slightly apart.
6.5s and she's through. It puts her second on the leaderboard of those who've completed. Behind Krista Palmer, ahead of Tina Punsell, those three have qualified. Palmer, Sabri and Punsell all through. Esther Chu,
always smiling. Lovely. Coaches all nodding their heads. Very happy with that dive. And consistency from the judges, from what I'm hearing.
There we go. No need to take out any of the outliers. Sevens multiplied by a coefficient of 3 gives her 63. She also is through. 63 gives her 309.15. She is the fourth person to qualify. Arantxa Vázquez, fourth overall. Let's see if she can maintain that position. She's looking a lock to qualify.
She managed to control it quite well. If we get a chance to see it again, I think she was quite a long way back on the board there. So you don't get as much springy, so therefore you can't quite get as high to get the momentum to fit in all of these moves. But she actually did that really well, considering.
61.5, not her best dive, but she's been consistent all day in between 61.5 and 67.5. Great consistency across the five rounds. She qualifies 318.6. Kim Suji, she was 12th after the fourth round. Now, this is going to be interesting to watch.
Yeah, this is her moment of truth, isn't it? Gosh, you have to have your head in the right place. You know you're right off on the cutoff point. A little bit too far back again on the board. It wasn't a bad dive. Whether it will be enough to keep her in the top 12, we'll have to wait and see.
It's looking unlikely. 3 6.5s, a degree of difficulty of 3. 58.5. She's behind the likes of Annabelle Smith, Emma Hallstrand, Michelle Heimberg and Maria Poliakova. It looks like it's not going to be enough.
Still smiling and being congratulated by the coaches.
She was 12th. Lovely. Haley Hernandez, 11th. Someone else who needs a great dive here.
I thought she was going to go off slightly sideways there, but she really managed to control that. Very good extension in the legs and feet.
6.5, 6.5, 6.5, 6.5.
Slightly let those feet come over. But really did put everything into that.
The most ambitious dive of the day, even though it's only a 3.0. 6.5 from most of the judges, 58.5 overall, and it's enough to qualify. 291.6, just ahead of Maria Poliakova, who is the one on the cusp at the moment. Mikami Sayaka, who obviously had a couple of tough dives.
Yeah, she needed perfection. I think we have to still obviously wait and see, but yeah, she had a real couple of tough dives, and that won't be good enough.
It's not. It's 54 points overall, 273.7, and that means that Maria Poliakova of the Russian Olympic Committee has also qualified. The next person on the bubble is Michelle Heimberg of Switzerland, after that Emma Hallstrand. But there's only 4 to go. Pamela Ware. She had a poor fourth dive, but surely she's going to pull it around this time around and nail that qualification.
Oh, no. That will be a failed dive.
That was a failed dive.
Pamela Ware, after 48 in the fourth round, is going to get a zero in this round and finish 18th out of 18. She was top three or four all the way through.
Completely and utterly stunned by that. It all looked good. She was slightly too far over on the board. You saw her toes come over, and then she just had no chance of controlling it again. I feel desperately sorry for her. Having dived so well in the preliminaries and up until now, it's very difficult to know what to say, really.
Agony for her, delight for Michelle Heimberg of Switzerland, who is now through and qualified.
Jennifer Abell had to really dig deep there and focus hard, having just seen what happened to her teammate. So credit to her for coming out here and doing a really lovely dive. She will be very, very disappointed. But everybody back at Jennifer Abell's club, the Pontclair Diving, they will be delighted that she has made it through to the finals.
One of the best dives of the day so far. 7.5s across the board. Degree of difficulty 3.4, 76.5. What a dive from her. Qualified good and proper as we see how distraught her teammate Pamela Ware is. On to the final two, Wang Han.
Another stunning dive from Wang Han. I can't believe that we're only getting a chance to see her at an Olympic Games, her first one at the age of 30. She's an absolutely beautiful diver to watch. Such great extension in the legs and feet. Been very, very impressed with her.
It goes without saying that she has qualified. She's currently top of the leaderboard. But for how long? Because the final competitor of these preliminaries, Shi Tingmao, is about to complete her fifth and final dive.
Oh, wow, that's what you call a ripped entry. Absolutely beautiful. Lovely on the twist and hardly any water coming up at all.
That was the best dive of the day. 9.99.27. Multiply that by 3.81. Finishing in style, laying down a marker for the rest of the field for the finals. Shi Tingmao of China wins the competition by 25 clear points from her teammates. As we look at Pamela Ware cutting a distraught figure, she looked an absolute shoo-in to qualify after three rounds. Had a poor fourth round, and you thought that she would be fine, and then disaster struck in the fifth round. You have to be consistent all the way across the five dives. Consistently brilliant was Shi Tingmao. Consistently excellent was Wang Han. Consistently strong, high-performance Jennifer Abell. Arantxa Vasquez, Krista Palmer, Noor Dabita, Tina Punsell doing very well as well. Esther Chin, Inge Janssen all qualifying. And then a few shake-ups in the final round with Haley Hernandez getting in 10th, Maria Podlyakova getting in 11th, and then it's going to make excellent reading if you are Swiss and absolute heartbreak if you are Swedish. Michelle Heimberg, 289.8. Emma Hullstrand, 288.85. Less than a point in it. It means that Emma Hullstrand and Annabelle Smith are the reserves, but the top 12 have made it through to the final, as we see. Arantxa Vasquez. There's a QR code for the families to dial in onto a Zoom call to congratulate or indeed commiserate with athletes there as we're seeing the lights of Enamoto absolutely distraught at not qualifying. It's the whole Olympic story. You can be so near and yet so far. You can prepare for four and then it becomes 5 years building up to the Olympics. And it can be all over in the space of one dive.
It can, and this really has gone to show it, hasn't it? It's such a shame for Pamela Ware in particular, because she was right up there. She would have been have a real chance of medals when it comes to the finals. And she will have done that dive so many times in training and done it really well. And the coaches are going to have to work hard. She will need to work hard to come back from this, because the amount of hard work that you put into your training to then come out at the Olympic Games in the semi-finals and do something like that and get a failed dive, I just find it hard to find the words as to how she must be feeling.
Particularly after qualifying so well for the semi-finals, she was in fourth spot. And it really is a taxing event.
It started
off at 27 competitors, whittled down to 18, and then 12 into the final. But if you have one failed dive at any point in either the preliminaries or the semi, that can completely and utterly derail your campaign. So what a session we have had. It was the women's 3-metre springboard semi-finals. We began on the fourth day of diving in Tokyo with the preliminaries, where we started with 27 competitors. We took it down to 18 who were here for this particular session, with only the best 12 to qualify. Five dives across the session, and we had heartbreak for some of the biggest competitors, none more so than Pamela Ware, who was fourth after the preliminaries. The Canadians could not believe it. She crashed out. That was her final dive. No way for her to come back. After that, it was a zero. She was out. She fell from fourth to ninth in the fourth round, and then 18th at the very end. Her teammate from Team Canada, Jennifer Abel, had to go in onto the board right after her. That must have been so, so tough after seeing a teammate crashing out. And then we had the two Chinese divers at the end, Wang Han and then Shi Tingmao, who were very much the cream of the crop. They were in the preliminaries, finishing second and first, respectively, and that was exactly the same in the semi-finals. Shi Tingmao leading the way, Wang Hang second, Jennifer Abel third, a great performance. So we had very much Shi Tingmao pulling clear of the rest towards the end. Wang and Jennifer Abel close in second and third, and then some excellent performances from the likes of Arantxa Vasquez, Krista Palmer, who came through at the end, Noor Dabita, who was solid all the way throughout, as was Esther Punzel, Esther Chin, who started off well and managed to be consistent from there on in. That was the case also with Inga Janssen. And then 10th, young Hayley Hernandez. Not the most complex of dives, but she did them all incredibly well. Look at that, 10th position, 291.6, 13th, 288.85. Heartbreak, perhaps, for Emma Hulstrand. So close for qualifying. She's only 20 years old. She'll come back. Pamela Ware, good to see her with a smile on her face. And I'm sure she will be cheering on Jennifer Abel when it gets to the women's 3-metre springboard final.